Tuesday, July 21st, 2015, at approximately 2:15 p.m.
Yeah, it's probably easiest.
This is a meeting of the Commissioners Cover Sheet Review Committee, duly... duly designated pursuant to the designated petition rules. Today's committee consists of the Board Secretary, Commissioner Bianca Perez from the Borough of the Bronx, and Commissioner Simon Simoon from the Borough of Brooklyn Republican Commissioner. Commissioners, we have both of some cleanup on the regular cover sheets, but mostly amended cover sheets to present to you for review. We'll do it in the order of the boroughs. We're going to begin by this morning, this afternoon, I should say, with Brooklyn. And Mr. Gregory Costantino, who's been the team leader for reviewing the cover sheets for Brooklyn, will make the presentations and will be able to answer any questions you have after the presentation as well.
Thank you. Commissioners, first, I have an NCM that we picked up regarding the county committee schedule. Their address is not listed, as you can see there.
Original. Yeah. But it's on the petition, so that should be given an opportunity to cure the schedule for the one individual.
And did they?
No, we have to give them notice. We just caught this in the cleanup, working with the candidate records unit. So our recommendation is we issue a notice of non-compliance, and we'd ask you to vote yes.
Yes.
By signing in the appropriate borough box or party box. Brooklyn.
Just initial?
Yeah, just initial. In the Bronx box. Yes. They'd have 3 days from today to cure. That's why we're going to do the cover sheet review committee next Monday.
Now, if you amend it. First, I have an amended cover sheet regarding the zip code. This is the state. So this is the amended cover sheet regarding the zip code.
The original.
Here it states there's a number missing.
They have the required certification. To our recommendation that this be done as a valid cure. The appropriate box.
The next, I have an amended county committee schedule. At first, they gave us the schedule, which is clearly cut off, so we sent them a notice.
That's the requirements, that's the language that they're authorized to file an amended cover sheet. Again, we're going to recommend that this is a valid cure. The original defense commissioner was that all the page numbers were in here, and that the last box of claiming submission signatures, they got the non-compliance numbers, it was timely filed. Thank you.
The next I have also includes a zip code. This is the cover sheet.
The alternate delegate, the original, was missing a digit. They filed it correctly, and we recommend again that this be a valid cure.
The next thing on the cover sheet I have is an address that was amended. Here it states 20 Highland Place. Well, this is the amendment. And here it says 20 Highland Street.
And again, Commissioner, this was reviewed by the initial committee. There was a printer's error letter which corrected the address, so then they had to conform the cover sheet to what was accepted as a printer's letter. They've done it. Now that is the correct address.
The last I have. Yes, remember, this is the one that he gave the extra page
right.
For the 53rd.
Commissioner, the county committee schedule was supposed to be for the 57th Assembly District. The original included a page from the 51st.
Okay.
So they got notice to cure, they filed the amended cover sheet, authorization to file the certified, and it's now only a two-page cabinet committee schedule for only the 57. So we're recommending that this be a valid cure as well. Tricia, this would be notice that went out. Telling them.
Excuse me, Steve?
Page three, this is the other district.
I need a receipt for the text that I gave you.
You're gonna stick around, right?
Huh?
You're gonna stick around till we're done?
I got a commissioner that I'm supposed to take back to Staten Island.
Well, the petition, they're not ready yet.
They're not ready?
To go back yet.
Okay, so I'm gonna stay put?
Yes.
So do I keep that?
Hold on.
All right, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
That finishes Brooklyn?
Yep, that finishes Brooklyn.
All right.
Thank you for your time.
Take your stuff and let Victor move down for Queens. Oh, no, we keep too much for even one for us.
Sure.
James, who's the contractor, he's got two, is that wrong at the box?
Run, get the kid back.
Sure. If he has to leave now, look at the little bit of it. Yes, I'll keep it on.
Well, commissioners, first one that I have is an attempted cure for a petition that wasn't fastened correctly. Here's the original one, here's the other one.
Commissioners, the notice defect told them they should have ordered a copy of the petition before the notice and then properly secure it. What they did was apparently they had their own copy of the petition and filed it because it doesn't have the volume ID number. And nothing else was attached to this, so it doesn't even know what the cure was. They didn't attach a copy of the notice. And you're supposed to, at least the instructions was to do that, and it was specifically by filing a copy of the petition, which complies with the requirements. The question is, without an ID number on it, how did we know what volume? We understood
it. It doesn't have that. The sticker, but it does have to have it. It's supposed to have the number. They could write it on it.
So I don't believe it's a valid cure. And apparently what happened to the commissioners, they came in originally and filed these individually, a single sheet petitions. So you can see the original, each one is clocked in separately. And that is the copy they have here on each of the pages, but the staff was correct to note that it didn't match a copy of our petition. So, and regrettably, even though it was an attempt to be successful, I don't think it's successful. We're recommending that about it. It's only for 6 a.m. Oh, this petition I think may be going anyway because it's somewhat light on signatures from member of the assembly.
It seems very small.
Yes. It's for the... It's still 5%. That was a little early. That came actually in about 45 that night.
This one is essentially the same thing, except this one does seem to be valid cure.
It was a page number. This was the petition, and there's a memo showing what happened. This petition came in right at the deadline at 12:01 p.m. Came in loose. They were inside the room before midnight, before we locked the door, before we processed it. Danny Lavelle has reported to the commissioner, Roger, inquired that in the course of copying the petition in response to the notice, our own staff put a binder clip on it. But this is the cure. We matched up. Every page is correct. This one, they did order a copy, and this is now securely fastened. So we believe this is a valid cure. Understood, Commissioner.
That's a problem.
This one was just a cover sheet defect. Very slight error. Here's the original one.
They put the wrong prefix on it. Should have been Queens. That's correct. It matches and it has the required certification. Our recommendation is that it's a valid cure.
Josh.
Here is an amended cover sheet. Here is the original. They had accidentally written down 36. They meant they wrote down pages in the volume, but they changed it to one.
The certification, all the other data matches. So, again, this looks like a novice.
I'm going to use our sample form.
Yeah.
And when corrected out properly.
You mean, you know what? Can work. It's fine.
You only had to do.
This next one is another amended cover sheet. This time they had written down the incorrect identification number.
The petition actually has, this was an administrative petition, is really listed in the 299. What happened is they were issued their original sticker, they put it on the cover sheet. When it came into CIU, they produced a duplicate sticker, which they're not supposed to, they're supposed to move the next order. So the correct number is listed as 299. We gave them notice that the cover sheet didn't match, and then they corrected it, now it matched 299. And they had the required certification language.
These last two are simply just defects within a county committee schedule. Right here, you can't really see the zip code, it's circled.
It's just, I think, a bad copy of the typo, but we looked at the originals the same way when we clicked it. And the zip code that the Postal Service has advised the board 3 years ago is essential to be able to get mail to you. Without a zip code, there was no way. So we give them notice that they corrected. And the only defect would be relating just to that one candidate. So we're going to ask you to authorize them notice of why it's not the correct match.
This one is essentially the same thing, except it just doesn't have a zip code. But it's circled right there.
That's it. Give them 3 days, so we're going to record it.
Doesn't have a state
either. Well, the state's not for, well, if you're running for a party position in the state, you have to be resident of the state. That's a statutory requirement. The only thing that the zip code is that, well, yeah. It matches the whole post office address, Hollis, you know, but without, at least if the zip code was there, it would get delivered. Because even in Queens, like in Bronx, if you didn't have it, but it was a Bronx, and you had the zip code, the 114, we would then, it would get there.
That's it for me, thank you.
You have the only Queens petition. When you go upstairs, let Queens know it's ready to be picked up.
Should he make copies of the
page for Oz and CIU and everybody else.
Right.
But the cure together with the original petition goes back to Queens.
Right. Thank you.
James, which borough first? Bronx or Staten Island?
Staten Island. It's much easier.
You want to get back,
don't they? Commissioner, you have a cure at the page number on the issue volume 150044. Originally, this is the original petition. Page 87 is the one that is off.
Yeah. Where the changes.
And on the cure, that's where the change occurs. On the original, it goes from 86 to 88.
So 86 now goes to 87, and they corrected them, each of the ones, all the way through to the end, corrected the question 9. So we believe this is a valid cure. Process, yeah, because if the page is a number, you don't know if it's missing or got lost. And if you're short by 5 signatures, did you read?
Because we have two cover sheets for candidates that do not appear on the petition. Mr. Castro and
Mr. Gilter.
Mr. Gilter. This is the first page
of the petition.
Where, can I see?
We haven't sent it yet. We haven't got, no, literally, commissioners, when we were doing the cleanup over the last week, this is why we came up. We have cover sheets for which the petitions don't match. So we're going to give them notice and ask them to come in and say, did they either put the wrong volume number down? We'll see, but right now it's a nullity because it doesn't match. So you get your defect sheets for them. Every page, crossed every cover sheet. That's how we found the defects now.
We have another one where the candidate appears on multiple volumes except for petition number 51. And that is
attached.
So this is petition number 51, and that's the first page of the petition. There is no district attorney on the cover sheet.
I may have just included it by error. Well, they can cure it however they want. We want to give them notice. But again, we're trying to do it. Make sure. And it's just related to that one volume.
Just the one volume.
And we'll make clear that that's
volume 51.
We'll get the Bronx.
Is that what that pile is?
No, that's Manhattan.
Manhattan. Action in Manhattan.
I'm sure this is a cure in response to our NCM for a candidate by the name of James Wilson. On the original cover sheet, should be attached to the actual.
That's the defect of the promise.
I'm sorry. On the original cover sheet, Mont Paul was the name on the cover sheet, but when compared to the actual petition volume,
660.
660.
It is Mr. Wilson.
It is Mr. Wilson for Manhattan.
So they cured it. They attached a copy of the defect notice to identify what they're curing. We're recommending that this is a valid cure. One was Herbert M. Brown, and the other one was Herbert Maria Brown.
Herbert Maria Brown, and Herbert M. They've attached a printer's letter, on this page here, correcting one of the petition volumes.
To match just the middle initial.
From to the full name. The original cover sheet
had this full name.
Had its full name. If you accept the printer's error letter, it's a valid cure. There is no cover sheet.
Well, no, there is.
No, well, the original cover sheet is the full name.
Full name.
Yes.
And then changing it to say that it should be the full name.
Correct.
And then the amended cover sheet has no reason. Okay, they found it's correct either way.
They followed along with the printer's letter.
So I think the only you have to act on is the printer's letter.
Has that already been?
No, this is coming to you. This is in response to the NCN notice that it didn't match. They submitted the printer's letter, so
they did.
So we're recommending it be accepted as a valid cure for the defect. And then the NCN will be withdrawn because the original cover sheet Herbert Maria Brown now matches the name of the petition as amended. Okay? Over here.
This one is the. NCM was sent out on July 14th.
Yeah, this was filed late. They had three business days, which would have been the 15th, 16th, and midnight Friday. This was filed yesterday. And that's the day of the notice. You confirmed the tracking that it went out.
The tracking's printed out. It's not attached to this. Yeah, this.
Yeah.
It went out on 14th. Yeah. And, yeah, this came in what? This
yesterday.
Came in yesterday.
Yesterday.
Yeah. Well, the deadline would have been, the deadline.
Then it would have been midnight Friday.
Yeah,
it's business days.
So, and then they could have delivered it.
We'll open till midnight Friday. So it was clocked in, we walked in and lived for a chapter. But we don't believe it's a valid appeal. Because it's late and we'll note that in the ledger too that it was a late fire. If you give them business days, but in this case it went out on Tuesday, they had to fire.
That was our track.
Yes. This is the, this is, this matches the, no, the number that we went out to them. And that's why we get it to the post office that night, and as you can see on the tracking, it was accepted at, on July 14th, and it was delivered, by the post office, it was delivered on July 15th.
Number three, business days from the 15th.
From the date of the, no, the date of the notice. So they had the 15th, all of the 16th, and all of the 17th. We're open till midnight on any day that's the filing is due.
So it's not 9 days from the receipt?
No. And the rule specifically, Commissioners, that you've adopted specifically provides that they have three business days as the Commissioners. Candidate may, within three business days of the date of a determination that the petition does not comply with the rules. Rule D4.
How about if they didn't receive this till after the deadline?
Well, again, we mail it to the address that they ask, we waive signature, post office guarantees delivery the next day. We're paying for that. Yes, we'll do it on the 15th. That's why we don't ask that for signature, because that's what some people always receive.
You know, sent back.
So this is a specific form of express mail for waiting for signature.
This isn't a chapter cure to NCN. The cure corrects the mistake on the address and voter house the building. However, part of the NCN also notified them of the fact that they sent two cover sheets. They're supposed to send one.
They claim for each volume, okay, 68 is one. 669 and 668 is the other. They're supposed to put them all together in one summary sheet. They repeated the same error. And we gave them specific notice here saying that 2B, filed two cover sheets for the same party position. That's supposed to correct it. Well, no, they're two. There was, the address was wrong. They corrected the address, but they still filed one for each volume. Which wouldn't give notice to anybody that they actually have two buy-ins.
It's not three, not B.
Not B. So that's why we think, Commissioners, it's not a valid cure. What? No, do each one. In case it gets separated, there's so much paper floating.
That's showing you being one.
You can explain. Is that the front?
How is it?
Now the wonderful borough of Manhattan. Which one?
Yay!
So
I gotta move to the bottom.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I was
Manhattan. She's really Manhattan.
Yeah. 2006, I moved to the bottom.
Okay. Now, why don't we, do we want to do the petition first? Larry, before you start, let's do the petition first. That's where we can get them back on the road to get the cars. Yep, bring the volume to the commissioners. Commissioners, in this volume, as they were working it, it was discovered initially, we're missing pages 88 and 101. '87 to '89, and then from 100 to 102. The one with the chance to cure the defect. Specifically, 125 jumped to 136, 186 went to 189. They ordered a copy of that petition. It has a copy of the notice so we know it's a curing. And then if you go now to page 121. It's securely fastened though. Commissioners, the beginning, this was 125 matched up. And then they made the changes which were consequentially numbered 126 all the way through because everything else changed. And then the second error got corrected because we no longer have a page 186. So we believe it's a valid cure. Because
that's what they find at the time. Before the 3 days.
Why they use it not number one as a cure. Any months this year?
Yes.
They only had 3 days.
Well, this is getting timely, but no, we've had a couple.
Yeah, she's supposed to get served for that if she's concerned. Last year, it's about 2 inches long.
It's the Maslow special. For,
he does that?
He did a couple.
Yeah, I'm sure he served it.
Yes.
And, this is a. Page underneath it on volume number 68. And there's a temperature.
I've got to make the count.
This is the attempt to cure, and that's the original volume. Page room defect, page 57, is followed by section page 48.
57, 48.
And that was the end of the
page. The original 48.
Yes. Very different. The cure
was the corrected, the second 48. So we think it's a valid cure.
Because they did it right here on the table.
They didn't want to make a second trip back. But they had to come up with their own scotch tape. We don't provide that.
You should sell them, you make money.
A vendor or something.
Right outside, get a little cart.
Hot dog stand, have a office supply stand.
That's the defect for this. All right, petitions. So do you have all the petitions now, or there's others?
We might need to refer to one of the two of those because of the way the
focus. Oh, okay.
So we'll take care of the separate time.
The CIU, yeah. Commissioners, this normally, for county committee, we usually go off the schedules. However, in the process of reviewing the filings, the candidate records unit identified multiple defects because there's either been over-designations in some districts, or in order to make sure that there actually was an over-designation in the given election district, they were looking at the actual petition pages of the county committee to make sure that the candidates actually appeared on them. As a result of that process, towards the end of last week, they began identifying to us defects. We've confirmed them, and now we're going to present them to you and give them the chance to cure them.
Commissioner Vesey, are you identified a candidate named Laura Dean Pierce Moss, County Commissioner? However,
claiming page
19 for 23 of the petition number 150 of the record. And we produced page 19 of that particular petition volume. We do have the original here as well, but you see here it's actually Jeffrey and Zanga appears for county.
So they claimed the extra page. So we want to give them the opportunity to cure that. And we'll get the letter. This is going to be a long night, a letter.
Every night at the office after Tuesday, meetings is a long night.
Second one that CRU comes by for us is for Candle Bar.
Page 29, Barbara Gamble was not appeared. They claim on the schedule.
This is page 29 of the petition, and her name is not appeared on the county.
It doesn't appear on the petition, it does appear on the county committee schedule, right?
Right, it appears on the schedule, not on the petition.
Right, they claiming page 29.
This is copy of the schedule.
The CRU found them on the other pages because we wanted to check for the over-designations. So we're recommending that they amend the schedule in effect to leave page 29 of this gamble. Okay, next.
Separately, there is an error on her apartment number between the county schedule as well in comparison to the petition. On the page that she does appear, her address is apartment 10D on the petition.
The schedule has 10G. But commissioners, most of the committees, the prior session, it's 10G, have not ruled an apartment defect being. Since the Postal Service will not set forth that that's an essential element of the address, the question for you is whether you think it's a defect or not. The committees in the past process doing this, with the exception, I think, of the first committee, which I think you were on, Commissioner Shulkin, they've been now voting that the address is not a major defect. The apartment number is a requirement. So we're going to, if you agree, Commissioner, we'd ask you to vote no.
Right.
You'll probably be proxy and not send the notice.
And then it would stand as okay.
It'll stand as okay.
Yeah, that's your reservation. That's IC as far as I'm concerned.
Okay, next one.
North becomes south. Okay.
The name. Okay.
I was staring at it for a second there. So the candidate's name on the petition versus the county committee schedule.
The candidate's name is here, Walter C. North.
On the petition.
On the schedule. Yes.
And it's on multiple pages. We have the volume.
It's like Kim Kardashian's new child.
Right.
So we believe that there's a defect. Which one is correct? We don't know, but that's up to them to see if they can come back and cure either with a Texas letter. But that did make us pause with exactly North. It was like a leather ball. This was completely the opposite direction.
I must have been really late or really early.
For the next candidate, on one of the pages claim of petition volume, the candidate's address is missing.
It's on the schedule.
So are we talking about Pennyola?
Well, yeah, the question will be is, depending, either they're going to try to do a printer's letter, or that maybe if they have enough signatures, just delete that page, and then they don't claim it, then there's not a problem on the schedule.
Can you say that again?
There are two, we're going to give them notice to cure, that the candidate, they claimed page
127.
Candidate's address does not appear on that. There are two possible ways to address this defect. One, if they think they need the signatures, they get a printer's letter and say it wasn't written right there, but it's all on the other pages. The simpler way is just if they have enough signatures, just delete this page.
Notice, would this reset the clock in terms of objections?
Well, just for this candidate, for one capital committee candidate. It doesn't start on the whole thing.
The NCN notice would kind of give them the option.
Well, again, it says that we're going to tell them on page 127 of the volume, the candidate's address doesn't appear. And we'll do, but there's two ways.
Then they'll start calling.
Then they may call and say, what's the way to do it?
That's a little too close.
That is.
So what is the way to do it?
There's two options. The easiest way is delete. Give us the amended schedule just for this candidate. Don't claim page 127, you don't have a defect.
I don't think a printer's letter.
Yeah, printer's letter's not going to be really good because it's, that to me, it's not like a missing zip code. Or they left off the three digits in the address. They left off everything, and it wasn't even close, because this is 564 West 117. Some people can even make a place, you know, both were living at Riverside Drive. Oh, it was there for both of them, it's not, it should have been written in the middle. I agree, I think the easiest way at this point to save the candidacy would be just to take off the page. That's my score, right?
So if you take off one page, they might be okay.
Okay. The address in this case is even a little more confusing. For the two candidates here, Commissioners, on the schedule, they have an address at 51 Hamilton Place in the past. On the petition, they reprinted their names in the address column. So I think, again, in this case, we'll give them the notice, but the easiest thing will be is to delete the page from that they claim. Yeah. This is the first time I've ever seen this, because I don't know what they were doing, except...
Yeah,
he's
copy and paste.
Well, I was going to say... So we're going to give them a chance to cure it. Okay, Larry, you have regular defects now. More regular defects.
First instance, we have two candidates. This is Green Earth, they appear on the cover sheet. However, we didn't note their names on page 1 of the petition. We sent them a defect letter, which they attempted to cure by filing a amended cover sheet indicating the page numbers that their name would appear on. Being the final was 104 pages, and we don't normally...
We don't go beyond the first page normally when examining it.
So what they did was they submitted an amended cover sheet, and...
But again, the purpose of this cover sheet is to tell people if they were to challenge a way to do it. I think the amended cover sheet meets that. That the candidates are mailed to are only listed on pages 21 to 104 of the volume. And receive credit. The district leaders are not listed on the first 20 pages. But in fact, if you look at the volume, only the delegates and alternates are listed on the first 20 pages.
We verified that.
We made a copy of page 20.
They're not listed.
They're not listed.
Then on 21, they are. And that runs all the way through 104.
So we believe this is a valid cure. If they did this initially, we wouldn't have had a problem because it would have told everybody, if you're in a challenge, you only go through these pages. The original cover sheet didn't have that language.
Deleting.
No, what they're saying is that for the candidate, if you look at the original cover sheet, they claimed the entire volume, they didn't tell us where.
This is the original.
Oh, that's
the original. Right, the original cover sheet. And that's why we only look at the first page normally, because we don't go beyond that. We sent them the notice that the candidate does not appear on the petition. Their response is, yes, we don't appear on the first 20 pages, we appear from 21 to 104. All the other required information is there, along with the statement of the certification. So, and they responded timely to the notice within the 3 business days. You know, it's just the amendment.
next filing, amended cover sheet for not listing the volume number. So we sent a defect letter for that purpose, and the it's amended to show that it's one volume.
If you look at the original cover sheet, they did put down the volume number, but they didn't have the requirement of how many total volume for the petition. They now added that in the amended cover sheet. One volume, the numbers are correct, has the required certification for an amended cover sheet. The attorney is that Luke had also decided to use his own form of the court order. Taught you a lot of new tricks.
Next filing, the candidates listed an erroneous petition number. They listed a number 151 on the cover sheet, and they amended it to show that the number should be 51, which is correct.
Reviewed by our team, it's found to be a valid, we're recommending it's a valid cure. Basically, it was a Scrivener's error. They typed 151 when it should have been just 51. The delegates and alternates.
Next line involves an incomplete name, and at first it seemed to have been corrected with a printer's letter, which commissioners have approved, and we found that there was some discrepancy in it.
The cover sheet.
And the candidates sent in an amended cover sheet, which attempted to cure that by amending the name to the full name. However, I'd like to just point one change out to Steve that was discovered today as well, is that the amended cover sheet omits the party name.
Here, it was handwritten in on the original cover sheet. And the name was, the Cheryl was missing. This is the many accepted the printer that the name should be Cheryl Jean Levitz. But yeah, this, despite the checking, you're right. See if they put it even in here, we can't. They didn't say which party of the district we are. I think we could, if it's a Republican district leader, then we would have gotten away with it. But you can't. I don't see how you can find this a valid cover sheet. Amendment cover sheet.
Was the other one stable too?
Well, if it's a different defect from someone else.
No, not the amended. This is in response. The defect was, the notice went out. After they accepted the letter, the original cover sheet had Gene. It didn't match this, so there was a commissioners approved, Commissioner Araujo and Commissioner Humane sending out a notice specifically. The printer's letter is deemed valid, and the amended cover sheet, the name doesn't match and should be changed. They got the notice to do that. That notice went out on the 14th.
Shouldn't the printer's letter be enough?
To change the cover sheet? No, the printer's letter applies to the printer.
It seemed like it continued.
Right. If the printer's letter was accepted, then the cover sheet is defective. That's what we did. So we accepted the printer's letter. We sent a notice out on the same day, on the 14th, telling them that the candidate's name on the cover sheet does not match the petitions as corrected. So they knew exactly what it meant. So in response to that, they timely filed on the 15th the correction. But since it was done on the 14th, they had the 15th, 16th, and 17th. So we didn't go to the committee immediately. They had a chance to file on Second Amendment if they caught it themselves. But the name of the party is essential to have a valid cover sheet.
Yep.
That's why we let the full. That's why we let the full 3-day cure period run. You have a, you can file as many amendments as you want within the 3 days, but we only give you one bite of the apple under us. That's why we changed the rule. We used to say, like, if it came in on the next day, we review it the next day, find it not valid, then they say they still have 2 more days.
It was attached to the old cover sheet.
Chad
party, but they're presenting it together. It was
handwritten on the first one. Can you
table this?
Well,
yeah.
Okay. Chad, keep
going. On our next petition, the candidate had an incorrect zip code. Had 2 separate petition filings. One of them was cured with a Prentice letter, but it was very specific.
Let's try to hold it.
So leaving the other petition, number 158, without a correction, and therefore disagreeing with the schedule.
Show them the
zip code here is number 10 to the 21.
And the cover sheet.
Cover sheet.
And the printed letter.
Yes.
Was not accepted by the committee because this doesn't apply because it's not related to Peter McCoy was here, but Peter McCoy doesn't.
This is 158, and right. That applied to 161.
Right. The specific, the reason was not accepted, the defect was on 158. They originally said on 151.
161.
Right. 161. So what's coming to the commission?
What's the defect?
And the cover sheet doesn't match the petition?
Yes.
Okay, that's the scam. Yeah.
Because of the existence
of the petition. So that's the address on the cover sheet does not match the petition. And the fact is this may be the correct zip code or not. But this is 6-5, but it doesn't match, and they never cured the printer letter. We never gave them the chance to cure the cover sheet. So they'd have to match the cover sheet to the petition.
We're
going to give them a chance. Yeah, because they filed the printer letter that went to the committee on the 14th. Give them a chance to cure the cover sheet. So it will match the petition. Call the printer's error letter, they made another error letter and they won't find it now. Not a good printer.
Where's the rubber stone?
At least.
I don't know. Goes up to the Bronco.
Yeah.
Okay, so
the next one. Go ahead. This is done.
I did petition one time. Never again. Really do it once.
That's my first. Best way.
The next filings represent our review of the ledgers, and we're able to discover some additional entries that need correction. In this case, the page numbers claimed for the candidate on the conference schedule don't match the position of the petition. So, we're going to send them a defect letter for the organization and try to get that correctly.
That's the same
problem. Page numbers don't match.
Yeah. I hope to put these two, let me, this is the same here. On the county committee schedule for Florence here. For Florence Mira, I believe is the correct pronunciation. Mena. They claim pages 45 and 53. This is page 53 of the petition. She doesn't appear as the county committee candidate. Florence Mena. M-E-N-A. So we want to get the right to correct. So it says, candidate does not appear on page claimed on schedule, which is 53. The other defects we caught prior, you're going to be reviewing the amendments for the others.
So is this to correct the defect?
This is to correct the defect. Because this is an invalid cure is the last one for the specified candidates.
In this instance, the address on the petition doesn't match the address on the cover sheet.
No, this is the box they'll slip on the gray seal. Cover sheet, they didn't have addresses. They filled the addresses in. They did the right cover sheet, signed the certification, but they left out the volume numbers. So for this candidate for the highlighted in yellow and red, it's an invalid cure. For the others, they never got a defect notice, so they're staying on the county committee. It will only be for the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. An invalid cure for just those. That's the problem with when you try to cure a defect, and instead of taking, I guess, what they had written in here, 239 on each of them, they didn't. So those candidates will advise them that they're not going to be on the county committee, and they'll be all devastated.
Could we all the money that we're going to lose on that?
What?
All the money they're going to lose by being on the county committee?
Yeah, well, yeah, I'm sure.
Which
since...
Which plate is this?
Do you know the candidate, Ms. Boxdale, but she did this herself as to amend it. Mr. Gregg usually wouldn't have made that mistake. So I think that's it?
Yeah.
Well, oh, the table.
Table marked as a yes.
Wait a minute. No. Marked as a valid cure, you mean?
No, marked as a defect.
It,
so it's being tabled.
So it went out?
No.
You're talking about, this is a...
So this was the cure.
Right, this is the one with the cover sheet at the party.
So now it's the cure.
Party, yeah. This was the cure, yes. The commissioners approved it on July 12th. The letter went out on the 14th. We did it, so 15, 16, no, it would have been, what, Tuesday, Friday the 17th. It's timely filed. The problem is it just doesn't have the party name on it. The good news is there's no opposition. The county, they can fill it at the county committee if they want. So that does, commissioners, thank you.
Thank you.
Congratulations on your first cover sheet review. You're an experienced veteran already.
Yeah, he's beating me punch.
If you want a second, I'll make you a copy.
Okay, great.